Hello everyone, and welcome to another exciting Super Metroid map randomizer race. This is winner's round two, between Nevdi and Mo. So one of these runners I think has been putting like a lot of practice into map rando, a lot of work, getting a lot better, really doing pretty well. And then the other one is Nevdi, so I think it'll be an interesting race to see what happens. Get to see if we have any right first game or just the straight left first, like usual. I think the left first is better. The door is way closer when you go to the left, so if you're wrong, it's not as bad. But yeah, should be getting started any second now. Curious how early of a morph we'll see. I think that some runners are better at more early morph, kind of straightforward linear seeds, and some are better at more of the complicated late morph, kind of silly stuff you have to do kind of seeds. So I don't think that Nevdi's very good at either, but I'm curious which kind of seed we'll get to see. Okay, so we have both runners going left first, so. And supers, so that's probably progression for something, maybe a door, maybe a like a top of business center elevator type of thing. Okay, and we got Mo saving, Nevdi not. I kind of like not saving when you only have to go that far to get the major. Or get the item. If you have to go right of the ship to get the item, I kind of like saving after that one. Oh, and screw attack. So that probably means that we have to go back to the left of the ship through the gauntlet area. So that map location, I would probably try going down, at least seeing what's down there. But it looks like both runners are just going to go over left of the ship, which I also think makes sense. Have to be a little careful here not to get softlocked. You could get stuck between two blocks. Oh wow, this is, yeah, once you see this room, I would really be regretting not checking more of the shaft that they got under where they got screw attack, just because this room is so long and annoying. Although with screw attack, that makes it a lot less bad. And Dragon, so yep. Yeah, that is a doable Dragon, technically. It would not be particularly fun, especially you'd actually probably rather have missiles than supers against Dragon, because Dragon drops supers way more often. Wave beam, So beams, I think in general, are going to be filler items. Although it's not the first filler item, because the first filler item would be an E-Tank. So maybe that wave is needed for something. I'm not sure. I don't completely understand the logic. I'm not Aussie, so. Okay, and yep, this is kind of what I thought might be here, so we should be able to get the map. It might be fan-tuned, though, so we might not be able to do it yet. Yeah, it is Fantoon. So it's interesting. You could fight Fantoon. Okay, it doesn't. And that's a different area. So if that were Fantoon, you could fight Fantoon with five supers. It kind of sucks. But with Screw Attack, it's doable. I'd probably prefer not to. Yeah, that's an awkward room to find as well. Mo also finding the turn off map station, and you had to not get stuck in there and empty. That would be a bad idea. Yep, that's the use for wave. So this is probably the right way. And that is Fantoon. Mo also deciding not to do it. I like not doing it. I think that that makes a lot of sense. And Mo not going this way. I think that I would probably, if I were Mo, go down here, because with Wave Beam, it's actually you can actually get back up. So that would be my thought. In terms of how to utilize that Wave Beam. It doesn't look like Nebdi really found much. Meanwhile, Mo is heading back up. Might be going through that Leodox room. Nebdi needs to be a little careful. Yep, made it through. And Nebdi not going down either. I really think that you should be going down there. And Nebdi will be fighting Fantoon on five supers, so this will be interesting. Nebdi on 62 energy can only take one hit right now. Okay, got a big energy drop, so now I can take two hits. Oh no. I think if you're. Oh my gosh. If you're Nevdi, I think that once you miss that super, maybe you want to just leave. Because trying to farm these supers is. These flames do not have good super drops. As you can see, he's farming like six flames at a time and still not getting any supers. This is. Oh, there's. Okay, never mind. So now he has the supers he needs. It's pretty easy to miss supers up against Fantoon, especially for Nefti. It's just they're a little faster than missiles, yeah. So they're a little bit different timing. Oh, and another super drop. So Nefti is getting hooked up with these supers. Probably wants to get a little more energy if possible. Okay, there we go. Small energy. I think that was the fourth super. It's hard to tell because of how many supers he's farmed for me, but meanwhile, Mo is over here. We'll be finding the same things that Nevdi found. Mo also has that E tank. That E tank is kind of a big deal. Can probably. Okay, so it was only the third super, so that's the fourth super. That E tank will probably let Mo go up. Worst room, and check the top door there. Oh, that was right super. Right super's interesting. Because, yeah, that. Fantoon doesn't actually open that yet because we don't have morph. But it will open it once we get morph. Oh, and here is Cryteria Shaft. Okay, and Nebdi finishes off Fantoon. Parlor, rather, is the room name. I know room names. Oh no, Mo. Okay. Not softlocked. It can't go down this bottom door, so. But yeah, this map knowledge is maybe gonna be big. We'll see. If Mo can come back with at least some number of missiles, and I think this is very likely morph. So right super is a major. I'm guessing this is morph, and then that is maybe a power bomb at maze. And then there's Kraid, so Or no, that's Rhaegon. We already knew where Rhaegon was. And that was space jump, not more. So what does space jump do? I didn't see what was that top right of criteria. Oh yeah, you can't go down, of course, you don't have morph. That's why they didn't do that. Is that maybe non-logic without it? So Nevi still has not saved. So this is a little scary. Nebdi getting through there. Meanwhile, Mo was coming back down after getting that space jump. Mo still not having any missiles, so cannot fight Fantoon any faster than Nebdi did. Gets to see that moat. Meanwhile, Nebdi over here. Oh, this won't do anything for Mo because no morph ball. Nebdi using my superior crouch jump strat there. Okay, so it is top right of criteria at Firefly. Yep, that is the answer. That's gotta be morph, I think. I don't think anything else gives us progression, so I think it has to be morph. Yeah, that would have been my first thought, getting space jump, and that's probably where I would have gotten as Mo. But just because that is so often the case in these map randos. Looks like Nebdi will be falling down the sand pit to get... Oh, we'll be taking a save and then falling down the sand pits. Probably. Mo looks to be farming some energy. We'll see if Mo decides to do the Fantoon after this. I doubt it. I think that you still want to just, like, follow that progression. Go back, get that top right of... Oh no, oh, that was pretty scary for Mo. Mo having that E-Tank has been kind of a big deal in this early game. I doubt that Nebdi will ever get that. Unless the seed is really withholding power bombs. In which case it's possible that Nebdi goes out of his way to get that. Mo taking a hit from the ghost needs to not take one more hit. But should be fine. Yeah. Yeah, the ship is right there, so Mo should be fine. Yeah, meanwhile, the ship is turned on for Nevdi. I didn't see what was at Spooky Missiles, but that item will be more annoying to get for Nevdi than it would be for Mo if Mo was able to get it before fighting Fantoon. Yep, and here's another use for that wave beam, so wave has been doing a lot in this early game. I feel like wave is going to have yet another use once, after morph, to go get the item at the bottom of the wreckship shaft from JLPBs. And yep, there's the morph. Nevdi right behind Mo on that, and Nevdi already having Fantoon killed. Only difference in their loadout is that Mo does have that extra E-Tank. Oh, and Nevdi losing space jump, taking a spike hit. Not ideal. And there is charge. So this is going to be just a save for Mo, which, yeah, I like not taking it. You're going to be back at the ship anyway. I'd rather save at the ship. The only reason to take that save would be in case you're afraid of dying coming down Firefleas, but I don't think that that's likely. Oh, and almost, kind of almost died there. Nevdy needs to not take a hit from the giant side hopper here. And does not, so gets through there. Yep, both runners taking the saves of the ship. I would expect to see Mo still not fight Fantoon. That looks like what is happening. Mo not going down here, so Mo will be missing on that major where Nefty knows that it's right there. I think that you need that major. I think that major and right supers are the only ones available. Maybe there's more. There is a hollow dot at Maze. Oh, and Nevdy is going this way now. So Nevdy will get an E-Tank, but we'll be giving some of that time that Mo spent doing this back. Mo is coming up here, checking these morph tunnels. Yeah, I think that this makes a lot of sense for Nevdy, actually. No power bombs yet, so kind of want to check that holodot. Even an E-Tank there isn't bad, so... Yeah, you have to be careful about how you wall jump through that room. If you wall jump wrong with screw attack, you're going to take a hit. Okay, so we'll see if this is power bombs for Mo. I would kind of guess that it will be, but... Yep, it is. So with power bombs now, there's a lot more that opens up. Yeah, this passageway opens up. And gets a power bomb drop. Nice power bomb drop. So yep, Nevdy will be checking what this major is. And it's ice. So ice is a beam, so it's a filler item. But it can have it can be also used for logic, so we'll see if that's required. Ice is one of the better items, outside of the suits and charge. Being able to Zeb skip in this, mode is really important. Even when you have charge, sometimes it's... Oh, did Mo... Mo didn't get that. So I think that Mo just forgot about that item, which is pretty unfortunate. It's not a huge deal, And Mo falling down here, is there a way back up? I don't remember. Spazer there. Speed, okay. So that's a big item. Yeah, I don't remember what the map looked like, and if it's okay that Mo fell down here. Yeah, if he has to go through Pillar's room, then not picking up that E-Tank is going to be a big deal. With Space Jump and Screw, I think that you can get back, but... Okay, and there's a save, so save helps. Makes it so that he will have multiple tries at this if he needs to. It does feel like Pillars is here a lot in the wreckship West Ocean area. Oh wait, he knew that Pillars was there. Yeah, it only takes less than 100 energy to get back through that, so. And going back down, so we'll see, okay, so Nebdi fell down here as well. We'll be getting the super. And another power bomb here at Indiana Jones. Oh! Nice, Nebdi. Shout out to Nebdi falling in vile plumes. It's like there's some sort of magnetic attraction that he just can't avoid them. Nevdi also picking up that spacer, so charge Ice Wave Spacer for Nevdi now. Pretty solid beam. That new route beam, plasma would be nice, but even with this beam, you're not super worried about supers now. Boss fights aren't too slow. And I'm curious if Nevdi will decide to go back for that Dragon. I think with suitless, with it being suitless, it's still a little too hard at this point, especially for someone like Nevdi, but it's doable. Meanwhile, Baron is over here getting these items. Still doesn't have the map, but does have 10 missiles. So now once Baron comes back to Fantoon, he'll be able to do it a lot faster than Nevdi was. And high jump. Okay. High jump and spring ball. Space jump makes it nice so that if you fall like that, you can space jump on the top of this water and get back. So it feels like there's going to be some sort of suitless stuff that they have to do with that high jump and spring ball. And it looks like Nevdi is not getting those items, so we'll see if this works out for Nevdi. I kind of feel like those items are going to be required. Nevdi taking a hit from the pirate. Oh no, Nevdi. Oh wow, I can't believe that Nevdi survived that. Yeah, and this is rough for Nevdi, because can you make it back past through that room? I think that, yeah, I like falling down here once you're here. You can always use the ice beam to freeze your way back up. Oh, and that is, at least Nevdi got to see that item, but so Nevdi is back where he needs to be now. Might have worked out better than than if he hadn't have found a kind of a dead end, something they couldn't do. Okay, Mo getting another power bomb here at Spooky Missiles. I'd imagine we see Nevdi probably do That Mama Turtle. No, Nevdy's going to Taurian now. So I think best case scenario here for Nevdy now is also a dead end here. No, because now that save. I think this is a worse save for Nevdy. Just because, based on where we need, we know that Nevdy probably needs to go. For Nevdy, maybe, I don't really know why he's not checking those majors. Maybe he just didn't see them. Maybe he saw them and just didn't want to do them for some reason. I'm not sure. Hard to not do two majors there. That's... There's Aqueduct, yeah. Oh no, and Mo dies. And doesn't have the missiles, doesn't have the high jump, doesn't have the spring ball. We'll be picking those back up, so... give us a little bit. I think everyone just got booted from the SG4 for a second. So, I'm not sure if the episode was accidentally ended for some reason. But we're working on getting it resolved. I'm guessing by the time it comes back up, we'll have Mo with Spring Ball and High Jump again. But I have no idea what will happen with Nevdy. That'll be interesting to see, because we'll have missed a little bit of Taurian exploration. It looks like Nevdy just found Rexship E-Tank.